In this video, we will briefly describe what the pressure temperature diagram that's shown in the figure represents. There's a couple things to keep in mind about this diagram. One is that it's a projection. What I mean by that, it's a projection of a three-dimensional surface of a pressure volume temperature diagram for a single component. So if we were to look on the side of a three-dimensional structure, this is the projection we would see. As a result, one point on the diagram can represent multiple things. And what I mean by that is it could represent, for example, a saturated liquid, a saturated vapor, or a mixture. So let's look at each of the parts of the diagram. The solid region is fairly self-explanatory. The critical point is the highest pressure temperature point where we could have vapor-liquid equilibrium. And the important things to note is that regions are labeled as liquid, as vapor, and as fluid, but there's no dividing lines. There's nothing that says when does it change from a liquid to a fluid. When does it change from a fluid to a vapor? We could certainly also refer to this region as a supercritical fluid because it's above the critical point. So the critical point is unique to each material. So what's very important to understand is what this line represents. So this is the pressure temperature line separating liquid from vapor. So if we're right on the line, so a point on the line corresponds to vapor-liquid equilibrium. That means that point represents, as indicated here, could be a saturated liquid, all liquid, could be saturated vapor, all vapor, where saturated means it's at its vapor pressure, it's at its saturation pressure, or it could be a mixture of partly liquid and partly vapor. And on a two-dimensional diagram, all these conditions shrink down to one point. If we move off of that point even slightly, if we increase the pressure slightly at the same temperature and go to here, then we only have liquid. If we increase the temperature slightly and go to here, we only have vapor. And it's important to understand this meaning of the fact that only at one temperature do we have vapor-liquid equilibrium for a single component material. In order to understand this two-dimensional projection, let's look at the other projection of the PVT surface, namely pressure versus volume. In this case, this is drawn very schematically. I've indicated this is the log of the volume because it can be a very large difference between the volume of the vapor and the volume of the liquid. So when we look at one point that's right on the line, that corresponds on the PV diagram to saturated liquid or saturated vapor or some point in between, infinite number of points in between, that is a fraction of liquid and a fraction of vapor. So the reason that as long as we're at this temperature, we can have both liquid and vapor in equilibrium. If we were to add energy, constant pressure, we would evaporate, get to a saturated vapor line. The one other important, interesting aspect of this diagram is if we notice this solid liquid line, drawn an arrow here to indicate that it continues off the scale. Other solid phases could exist at much higher pressures, but there's no corresponding critical point. And so the critical point means that if I look at this diagram and I were to start here as a liquid, a pure liquid, I could, for example, raise the pressure to here, then at constant pressure, raise the temperature and go to here, then at constant temperature, lower the pressure and go to here. And so I've gone from a liquid to a vapor without a phase change. I've circumnavigated the critical point. There was no demarcation. There was no obvious point where it was no longer liquid. It was a fluid, no longer a fluid, but a vapor. So I could start out with a liquid, go through these pressure and temperature changes, and then take this and at constant pressure, see a phase change as I went back towards the original point. It's useful to draw this pressure temperature diagram when considering single component systems because it can be very useful in solving understanding processes that take place as pressure and temperature are changed for a single component.